I'm often asked whether I'm a birder or a photographer. Well, actually, I'm a birder. I only recently became a photographer through necessity, so I could do books like the Crossley ID Guide. Now, obviously, there's an awful lot of photos in there taken by yours truly. So I'm often asked the question, how do I get to take so many photos and how do I get to so close to birds? Well, I think of birds just like people. The things that scare birds scare me. So, bright colours don't affect me. I don't think they affect birds either. Believe me, they can see us coming. You know, we're looking for something that's 6 or 10 inches and we're 6 foot, we can see them but they can't see us. I don't think so. So, what do we do? Well, move slowly. Obviously, if we move slowly, it doesn't scare them. Sudden, quick movements do. Have you ever noticed if you drive past a bird in a car, it stays still. It doesn't fly away. But the second you try stopping the car, guess what? Off it goes, right? Because there's a sudden change in movement. Size makes a difference. I'm intimidated by big people. So are birds. So if you keep low, not a problem. And sound, the same thing. If somebody makes a sudden scream, I jump out of my skin. So do birds. Maybe you've been to a workman's site and they have the radio blasting. And funnily enough, it doesn't seem to affect the birds. Why? Because it's a constant sound. I can promise you, when it first went on, that radio, I'm sure birds flew to the hills at the beginning. So, it's the sudden changes. The things that scare you and scare me, scare those birds. So, just think of how you'd like to be treated, and I'm sure you can walk right up to the birds as well.